coverage you can count on. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness News Weekend Today in HD.
Never mind, I thought it was two. Mic check, 1, 2, mic check, check, check.
Mic check, hello, hello, mic check, 1, 2, 3.
Coverage you can count on. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness News Weekend Today in HD.
Good morning, Tennessee Valley, and thanks for waking up with us here in Eyewitness News Weekend Today. It's Saturday, February 11th. I'm Natalie Potts, joined live with meteorologist Nick Austin for our first look outside this morning. Good morning.
Good morning, and good morning everyone out there. Yeah. You made it to the weekend.
It's finally Saturday.
And, it's finally Saturday.
But
I know.
What, are we going to need to bundle up today?
Not at all. It's actually going to be a fairly warm weekend. We're not going to have a lot of sunshine, though. That's the downside. Take what you can get, right? You have to take the good with the bad sometimes. It is cloudy right now, but it's a mild 55 degrees. That's nice. That's a little bit, a degree or two warmer than the normal high for this time of the year. So we're starting off pretty warm. And we will see just a little bit of light rain and drizzle off and on today developing. That's about it. It's not going to be a lot of heavy rain. It won't be raining all day, but off and on we'll see some spots of light rain and some drizzle, and then more of a way of just kind of scattered showers off and on tonight. But we'll have highs in the mid-60s today, so that's still, despite the cloudiness, it's still pretty warm for a mid-February day.
54. So this morning, right now.
Right now, it's in the 50s.
Wow. So
But I'll have the 7-day forecast, the Valentine's Day outlook. That's all coming up in just
that's
a little bit.
That's what we are all
yeah, a lot of folks
forward
want to know.
To.
Do I need my umbrellas when we go out for dinner on Valentine's night? I know. I'll let you all know in just a little bit.
All right. Thanks, Nick. In a top story this morning, the Hamilton County Sheriff's Office and local fire crews responded to a fire on Mahan Gap Road early this morning. Dispatch tells us that a vacant barn caught on fire around 2 a.m. Officials say no one was injured in the fire. The cause is still under investigation. Chattanooga police are investigating a late night stabbing last night on O'Neill Street. It happened just before midnight. There is no word yet on the status of the victim. This is a developing story. Stay with us on air and online as we learn more. Chattanooga's mayor and those hoping to unseat him debated some of the bigger issues facing Chattanooga last night. Mayor Andy Burke, City Councilman Larry Groin, David Crockett, and Chris Long took part in the discussion hosted by the UTC College Republicans and Democrats. All of the questions came from current students and members in the audience. Channel 3's Kelly McCarthy shows us what the candidates are passionate about.
UTC students organized the first debate between the four mayoral candidates. And in this debate, we heard each candidate explain his vision and how he would improve the city of Chattanooga.
We got to have development, diversity. I want opportunity for everybody. Everybody's important to me.
Candidates talked hopes and challenges with housing, homelessness, and crime.
I am running because I want to stop the incredible slaughter and maiming of our young people in this city.
Our violent crime is down, but we have this persistent gun violence. We have to do something about guns. We've seen this not just in Chattanooga, but around our country.
As Mayor Burke focused on his hope for the future.
I'm more optimistic than ever about what we can do. And I think that that gives me the confidence that over the next 4 years, we'll make even more progress.
Other candidates criticized his administration.
As a failed violence reduction initiative, a failed affordable housing program, a failed workforce development program.
This is by far the worst administration in the city's history. And in most cities, most organizations in Chattanooga, the mayor would have been removed.
In 1 month, it's up to voters to choose the city's next leader.
I will put people to work and I will get people on the opportunity track. And we will look forward.
I am so happy to hear what I'm hearing tonight. Reason why is we're talking about issues that we haven't talked about before.
The candidates also answered questions on homelessness, affordable housing, and how to make young people stay in the city. These four candidates will meet again in 10 days for a forum at the East Gate Town Center. In Chattanooga, Kelly McCarthy, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Thanks, Kelly. The Hamilton County Sheriff's Office is asking any witnesses to a crash that killed a cyclist yesterday to come forward. 19-year-old Cameron Reese was riding his bike on Suck Creek Road when he was hit by a vehicle just before 10 a.m. Reese was taken to the hospital where he died. Deputies have not released the name of the driver. If you or someone you know witnessed the deadly accident, the Hamilton County Sheriff's Office would like to talk with you. Chattanooga police are hoping new security cameras will make the scenic city a safer place to be. They're using a system called Crime Eye, and police say it'll help catch criminals in the act. The city plans to start by putting 15 cameras in specific areas of Chattanooga, and one of those cameras is already up on West 38th Street. Police say the next set of cameras could be placed near UTC and in Red Bank. Friday was part of a long weekend for lots of students and teachers across the Tennessee Valley as a number of school systems in our area canceled class again due to the flu and other illnesses. That list includes Sequatchie County, which is also closed this Monday. Doctors say flu germs can spread to others up to 6 feet away, and closing schools for a few days, well, they say it's a smart choice. More than 3,000 students and hundreds more teachers were absent from school yesterday in Hamilton County alone. A nurse practitioner from CHI Memorial tells us what you can do if the flu spreads to your home and how to keep it from spreading even further.
Rest as much as possible. The body recovers best when you're well rested. If you do have people in your home who are already sick, we encourage you to wash your hands often with soap and water or with a hand sanitizer.
The CDC says 43 states have now widespread flu activity. Tennessee is reporting regional flu cases. We'll continue to keep you updated. You can look for school closures on our website at WRCBTV.com. A Bradley County man is searching for the owner of a lost World War II Purple Heart. The medal was found in an abandoned storage unit in Ringgold, and it has the name Darrell O'Fuller engraved on it. Sam Alawat was scrolling through Facebook Marketplace when he spotted an ad saying Purple Heart for sale. Channel 3 reached out to the man selling it, who tells us it is all a misunderstanding.
You know, I did try to find the owner. If I could, I would, but it's a replica. It's a replica. You know, you can buy a replica of everything nowadays.
Well, he called the VA, who told him it is a collectible item and not an official Purple Heart medal. It is illegal to buy, sell, barter, or manufacture any decorations or medals authorized by Congress for the United States Armed Forces. If you know the family whose replica Purple Heart belongs to, we have Paul Lee's contact information on our website. Valentine's Day is just around the corner, and if you're looking for some love in your life, we have a four-legged speed dating event for you that you might be interested in. It's today from 10 a.m. until 4 o'clock at McCamey Animal Center. Animal lovers will have the chance to meet adoptable dogs and cats in hopes of making a match. Participants will have up to 8 minutes to create chemistry with each animal, all of whom have individualized biography cards to help pet seekers find their perfect match. Well, there will be a polar plunge today at Finley Stadium, and Channel 3's Tanisha Cordell joins us now live with more. Good morning, Tanisha.
Good morning, Natalie. Well, yes, I am here at Finley Stadium with Jennifer McAvee here. She's a Special Olympics coordinator here in Chattanooga. We're here for the polar plunge that's going to be taking place here at 10 o'clock today, so you don't want to miss it. This is actually one of the biggest fundraisers in the area for Special Olympics, and there's thousands literally all across about 9 counties wide. Is that what we're talking about, Jennifer?
Yes, we are covering 9 counties. This is our biggest fundraiser. Our goal today is $20,000, and we're really close to making it, so we're excited to see what happens as people show up with more donations today.
Now, talk about that. I know you said donations. So yes. Talk about how, you know, people are, you know, are donating and what they had to do to compete or participate today.
People have been fundraising on behalf of Special Olympics. They've been raising money, asking people to donate toward their plunge. It's a $40 minimum for students, $50 for adults. And they come, take the plunge, jump in our pool, and the more money they raise, they get more incentive prizes. So it's just an exciting, fun event.
And I see we might spot some characters today. Talk about that.
Yes, we have a fun costume contest. Starts at 11 o'clock today. I know we have a Hawaiian themed team that'll be coming out. I've heard rumors we have a banana jumping in today. So it's always fun to see what crazy characters and costumes come out to plunge.
What's been your favorite costume or character you've seen since in all your time doing this? What's been your favorite?
Yes, definitely the Minions. First year we did it here 3 years ago, the Minions jumped in, and that was by far very fun costumes.
Wow. Well, we'll have more coming up. It's coming up at 6:30. I'll take you inside the pool and see just how cold plungers are going to be diving into, how cold that water is. Stay with us, Natalie.
All right, thanks, Tanisha. Well, Dollywood reopens in a little more than a month, and when it does, visitors will find several new attractions built during the winter downtime. A junior kids-friendly coaster called Whistle Punk Chaser is going in next to the Thunderhead coaster. A new ride called Drop Line is being built in the same area, and the tower will lift guests about 20 stories and then drop them. Dollywood Splash Country is adding a 6-story, 6-lane racer called Tailspin, which will be its first new attraction since 2013. If you're planning a spring break trip, Dollywood reopens to the public on March 18th. In national news, heavy rains proved too much for levees in Northern California. 3 levees breached along the Cosumnes River in Sacramento County yesterday, flooding neighborhoods and washing out roads. An evacuation advisory was issued, but as night fell, people who didn't leave were told to shelter in place, and the water stranded some livestock. Local leaders warn of the possibility of more flooding today. Caught on camera, Florida police rescue a driver from a burning car moments before it explodes. Police say 44-year-old Philip Thistle crashed his car into the concrete barrier. He was able to get out of the car, but couldn't move much further. Dash cam video shows three police officers rushing in, pulling him to safety before the car burst into flames. No word yet on what caused the crash. Police say Thistle is expected to make a full recovery. When we come back on Eyewitness News Weekend today, Nick Austin will have a full look at your forecast. Plus, we'll take a look at your community calendar. Stay with us. All right, and the days before Valentine's Day, flower producers in Colombia are hard at work. The South American country is the world's second biggest flower exporter. In some past years, flower exporters faced a loveless Valentine's Day due to poor crops. But hey, they say this year is going to be a good year. Workers at the packing plant usually put together more than 250,000 boxes in the 2 weeks before the big day. And that's a whopping 65 jumbo jet full of flowers. Close to 80% of the flowers imported by the U.S. come from Colombia. Pretty sight there.
Learn something new every day.
Yeah.
I really had no idea. I mean, we all know they make great coffee. They have great coffee beans.
Right. Who
knew? Didn't know about the flowers.
Well, makes sense.
I had no idea. So, hey, lots of choices. Valentine's Day is coming up on Tuesday. So
I know, it's right around the corner.
This is the weekend to get those last minute gifts or whatever.
Don't scramble. You know, don't wait till the last minute.
Might need your umbrella, but it's not going to rain all day. So that's the good news. Then it's going to be kind of warm. So for those who don't like the cooler weather that we had for a little while, here's our Holiday Inn Live downtown camera. Pretty good shot there of the city, but skies are cloudy out there. It's going to be a relatively warm weekend, though. That's our top weather headline. Temperatures will be well above normal during the day and at night as well. We could see just some light rain through the weekend, and then it gets cooler again next week with temperatures back down to around normal. A little bit of patchy fog, some dense fog too, from near Cagle Mountain in Grundy County around Grootley Lager. The Palmer community could be seeing some of that fog there, so just be careful traveling through those spots. The rest of us are in pretty good shape. We have temperatures in the 50s and 60s across the state, down towards Atlanta and Birmingham as well. Right now it's 55 here in the city. That's just a little bit warmer than a normal high for this time of the year, so we're starting off really warm. But way out in Murphy, North Carolina, at least at the airport in Murphy, which is closer to Andrews, North Carolina, it's 35 degrees, maybe a little closer to 40 in downtown Murphy. That's the cool spot. 55 Athens, 52 down in Dalton. And winds are variable in direction right now, around 5 miles per hour in the city. So the winds aren't really a big factor at this point. We'll see the breezes picking up a little bit during the day, but the skies have been clouding up through the overnight hours. It's a low level overcast right over the Tennessee Valley. Thicker cloud cover up along the Ohio River Valley. And into the northeast, where there are still some snow showers falling here and there. A little bit of light rain across parts of the mid-Atlantic. Low pressure system and a cold front out in the Plain States. That will bring us a little bit better of a chance for rain tomorrow. Today, though, we're looking at spots of light rain, maybe just some drizzle in a few areas, especially high elevations. And then same for tonight. Then the cold front comes through during the day on Sunday, right around the late morning or midday hours. So we'll see a few scattered showers on Sunday, and then temperatures will cool off during the later part of the afternoon, and we'll continue that trend, of course, into the nighttime, and then skies will clear out for Monday. And it will get cooler next week, but at least it'll be a nice day Monday. That's when the sunshine comes back. If you're looking for any sunshine this weekend, you will probably be out of luck. We'll have cloudy skies today, but a high of 66, pretty mild, and just a few spots of light rain and drizzle here and there. South winds at 5 to 10. Keep your umbrella handy this evening. Again, not a lot of heavy rain. It's not going to be widespread over the whole area, but we will see a few scattered showers developing tonight. 58 for the low. That's really warm for a low temperature in mid-February. Your 7-day forecast, a high of 70 tomorrow. How about that? And I'll give you about a half a chance for rain, 50-50 in your neighborhood tomorrow with that warm high of 70 degrees here in the city. And then a beautiful day Monday, not bad, 55. That's nice for this time of the year. Plenty of sunshine. Valentine's Day near the mid-50s. If we see any rain on Valentine's night, on Tuesday night, it probably won't be until the late evening or after midnight. So I think, at least at this point, it looks like most folks can get their Valentine's Day in plans on Tuesday evening, and they probably won't run into any rain. A few showers on Wednesday, but temperature's not too bad. Pretty close to normal on Valentine's afternoon, so.
All right, looks good. Yeah. Hey, let's take a look at your community calendar for the weekend. If you're looking for something fun to do, the Leap and Lemurs event will be held today at the Tennessee Aquarium.
This sounds like a lot of fun. The event begins at 2 o'clock, just runs for an hour. It includes a sneak peek at the Lemur Forest, which is a new exhibit opening this spring.
I love lemurs.
I know, they're kind of cute.
I actually played with one, and his name was Lamar, which, what a perfect name,
Lamar the Lemur. Yeah. How about that?
And they are so much fun to watch. After the break on Eyewitness News Weekend today, Paul Shaheen has your sports news, an update on your UTC Lady Mocs, plus highlights from high school basketball. Stay with us.
Joining the Southern Conference in 2014, East Tennessee State has been owned by the Since rejoining the Southern Conference in 2014, East Tennessee State has been owned by the Lady Mocs. To be fair, though, the UTC women have done that to a lot of teams. But for those counting, the Lady Mocs had won six straight over their in-state rival since returning. Number 7 was on the line last night in Johnson City. Not a great start for the Lady Mocs. This is a turnover, and this is defense into points for ETSU. 3 points. Shamariah Bridges and Chattanooga trailed by 6 at the break, but the Lady Mocs turn it up in the third. Queen Alford slashing to the rim and the foul. They're working it outside now. This will be Chelsea Shumpert knocking down threes. Chattanooga outscores ETSU 26-8 in the third. The Lady Mocs roll 70-62. Meanwhile, on the prep beat, the state of Tennessee is almost a week away from any form of postseason play. Not the case in Georgia. It's beyond heated up at this point. Region chips were on the line last night. Our first stop was the Region 6A Boys Championship, Northwest Whitfield at Lafette. Luke Shiflett gets things started. The reverse layup to hit the deck for the Bruins. Then it's Grant Terry with the pump fake that fools everyone, draining the three to put the Bruins up four, but Lafette didn't let that lead get away. Austin Shopshire, the bucket with ease, and then Alex Kelleher pulling up for three. Just like that, the Ramblers are in front. But Caleb Curry counters, runaway flush, hang on to that rim. Northwest Whitfield edges Lafette by two, 53-51. On the girls' side, Region 6-4A title, Northwest Whitfield and Heritage. Two teams they played already, and they split in the regular season. This is Sydney Smith hitting the short jumper to pull the Generals within three. Other end, Riley Merritt dials up from the corner. Northwest Whitfield led 31-17 at the break. All Lady Bruins after that, 72-49, your final score. Lady Bruins take the region crown after four straight years finishing runner-up. You know, there's been a lot of firsts for the Chattanooga FC. Today marks another, their first game against the Major League Soccer team. Just so happens, it's Atlanta's first ever game as well.
They're very excited, probably a little nervous, you know. I mean, they realize that it's a David and Goliath kind of matchup. But, yeah, you know, they're excited. They know that there's going to be a lot of fans out, and they always want to perform when they're here.
Here's the details now. Tickets still available. It's a 3 p.m. start inside Finley Stadium. Decent weather ahead, so expect a crowd. Nick Austin will have you covered as far as that weather stuff goes. I know nothing other than it's decent weather ahead. That's it for sports. Always more online and inside our app. Have one heck of a weekend.
While most of us were preparing to watch the Super Bowl last Sunday, a Marine driving a truck through Colorado was stuck on the interstate. His truck broke down and he was there for 4 hours until a stranger whose son is also a Marine learned of his troubles and offered a hand. It was the beginning of a friendship. Dan Grossman has more.
It's funny how these things happen. You know, how we meet, interact, bond. like the way Shauna Zelenka did this past weekend.
You talk about it and you just get goosebumps. It's just a wonderful feeling that I was able to help him and get him off the road.
It was Sunday. As is typical, Shauna was browsing through a Facebook page for Marine families missing her deployed Marine when she came across one post from a mother in Iowa. It mentioned Newcastle, Colorado, a town only 10 minutes east of Shauna's home in Silt.
I saw that this Marine who had just been discharged from the military was stuck on I-70.
I was like, I'll take all the help I can get.
That Marine was Chris Sims. He was traveling through Colorado on his way home to his wife and kids in Iowa.
I pulled over to get some diesel, and when I turned into the gas station, I felt my wheel bearing go out in my truck.
He's like a son to me, like he's family, you know, and I would be devastated if my son was traveling across the country and he was broke down and there was no one there to help him.
I bet you can guess what happened next.
We didn't think that we could find a mechanic, and a girlfriend of mine, her boyfriend is a mechanic in Newcastle, and he was able to get his truck in to get it repaired.
Yeah, I just gave her a big hug and gave her husband a handshake.
Sure, it was a simple gesture, but it spoke volumes of the relationship between two strangers who share a common bond.
Oh, I almost cried. I mean, he will just be a long-distance son.
A bond any military family can understand and cherish.
Yes, it's great.
All of our local news and weather when we come back on Weekend Today. See you after the break.
Can count on. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness News. Coverage you can count on. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness News Weekend Today in HD.
Good Saturday morning, Tennessee Valley, and thanks for waking up with us here on Eyewitness News Weekend Today. I'm Natalie Potts.
I'm meteorologist Nick Austin, and hope you're having a great morning so far. And
yeah, good morning.
Hope you made it through the week in one piece.
Well, you know what? When you step outside this morning,
it's
warm.
Very mild, yes. It's warm out there.
We had some chilly days.
Temperatures in the 50s. The
past few days, so
yeah.
It feels nice, but you said what? We won't see the sunshine very much?
Yeah.
We're just going to feel it.
Very, very little, if at all, this weekend. Especially today. Maybe a little sunshine by the end of the afternoon tomorrow, but mostly cloudy skies.
Can't have both.
But if you like the milder weather, then you'll get your wish, that's for sure. Because skies clouded up overnight, south wind. Now temperatures are in the 50s.
Yeah.
Like our normal high temperatures are where we're standing right now.
I know, it's just crazy.
Yeah, we'll take a look, see if there's anything popping up on the radar yet, even though we have cloudy skies. Not much in the way of any rainfall, that's for sure. But I think during the day, we will see a chance for at least a few spots of some light rain or maybe drizzle to develop, especially in high elevations, but could happen here in the city later on in the day. Just keep that in mind if you're heading to the CFC game. I think it's at 3 o'clock. Is that what Paul said on the sports?
Mm-hmm.
I think it's 3 o'clock this afternoon. So it'll be mild, but there could be a little bit of light rain or drizzle around. So you want to, you know, maybe bring one of those plastic ponchos in case you need to stay dry. And it'll be warm, though. It's 55 right now. We'll be in the mid-60s later this afternoon.
Or you could just take it all in with the experience.
That's right. Yeah, or you could just not bring any rain gear and maybe get a little wet. I mean, we're not talking about heavy rain here, but some light stuff, maybe some drizzle, could be around by the time the game starts.
All right. Yeah. Thanks, Nick.
You bet.
In your top story this half hour, a Chattanooga man is behind bars accused of sexually assaulting a teenage girl at a school bus stop. It happened on North Willow Street as the girl waited for the bus. Police say Donta Williams admitted to touching the girl several times, even when the girl tried to get away. Channel 3's Tanisha Cordell tells us why Williams is no stranger to law enforcement.
Around 6:30 Wednesday morning, Chattanooga police were called to a school bus stop on North Willow Street. That's where a 15-year-old girl told police she was sexually assaulted by 23-year-old Donta Williams while waiting for the school bus. According to court documents, Williams admitted to rubbing the girl and trying to kiss her, despite her trying to walk away. Police say the man returned to the stop the next day, and the girl was able to identify him.
It is a child's right to wait safely at the bus stop. It's anyone's right to go out in public safely and engage in their daily normal activities of daily living without the threat of somebody sexually assaulting them.
CPD's victim services coordinator, Carolyn Huffaker, says 1 in 4 women will be sexually assaulted in their lifetime. 1 in 33 men will be victims of the same crime. But the majority of sexual assaults are never reported.
When you have an individual that behaves in such a way and is such a dangerous threat that is going to act potentially violently, so publicly, it's certainly concerning.
Huffaker says this case is a good reminder to teach children and teens to always be aware of their surroundings. Residents living nearby can also play a vital role in safety.
Be a participant and an active bystander. If you see something, say something, speak up. You know, you can intervene if safe. It may not always be safe, so that's why we always want to say follow up with calling 911.
Above all else, Huffaker has this message for victims.
Even if you engage in all of those risk-reducing behaviors that we talk about in classes, and you're still sexually assaulted because of a choice that somebody else made, it's not your fault.
Donta Williams' criminal history includes multiple assault charges. Hamilton County School System has provided some bus safety practices. You can find that link on our website, wrcbtv.com. Well, Durham School Services wants a federal lawsuit filed in connection with the Woodmore bus crash dismissed. An attorney filed the lawsuit in December on behalf of a survivor of the crash that killed 6 children, but Durham's attorney argues the company should not be held liable for the wreck because the driver, 24-year-old Jonathan Walker, was driving over the speed limit and not on the correct route. Walker faces 5 counts of vehicular homicide. The company faces 8 pending lawsuits tied to this crash. The family of an inmate who died while in custody is suing Bradley County, its sheriff, and 3 correction officers for $5 million. Ralph Nelms was found hanging in his cell in September, days after he was arraigned for a string of burglaries. The federal lawsuit claims the sheriff's department did not properly train or enforce its policies or supervise the jail. The family says Nelms was on suicide watch at the time, which means staff were required to check in on him periodically and document it. Instead, investigators say the 3 corrections officers forged the jail logs to show visits they did not make. The 3 officers are each charged with official misconduct. The person hit by a car Friday morning on Suck Creek Road has died. It happened around 9:30 a.m. Deputies say 19-year-old Cameron Reese was riding his bicycle when he was hit by a car. Reese was taken to the hospital where he later died from his injuries. Deputies have not released the name of the driver. Anyone who may have witnessed the crash is asked to call the number that you see there on your screen. A proposed bill in the Tennessee legislature could ease some of the costs for new parents. The bill would eliminate the tax on diapers. This isn't the first time, though, that lawmakers have tried to pass a bill like this. One was proposed last year but failed. Parents we talked to say the bill would free up money to spend on other necessities.
It's a lot of money on top of everything else that comes with a new baby. And if you're like me, you also have to worry about paying for childcare on top of that. So everything, it starts adding up after a while.
The bill would also eliminate tax on feminine hygiene products and over-the-counter medications. Similar bills have been pushed in other states. A Georgia bill is moving through the Senate that would make it illegal to take photos or film video under someone's clothing without consent. The gap in the state law came up this last summer when the Court of Appeals found a man did not do anything illegal when he filmed videos up a woman's skirt at a grocery store. A Senate committee has approved the bill. The House is now considering a similar proposal. A popular Chattanooga bar is standing behind their new controversial dress code. Southside Social released the new policy on its Facebook page. The business will no longer allow patrons to wear hooded sweatshirts, shorts below the knees, jerseys unless it's game day, sunglasses after dark, or loose or baggy clothing. The new dress code also prohibits backward baseball caps and do-rags. The Facebook post has received hundreds of comments voicing frustration with the new policy. It's been shared more than 400 times. Now that Chattanooga's Ironman 70.3 finished first in the best race venue experience, well, the city wants to see more races come to this area. That's according to a survey of more than 55,000 Ironman participants. The survey was released by the Public Relations Department for Ironman. A spokesperson for a local hotel downtown says the race is important for the city's economy and they do everything they can to cater to the needs of the racers.
We tend to have bike washing stations outside for the high-end bicycles. We have special microfiber fabrics to clean off their bikes, and we set up a custom breakfast for them that is very nutritional.
Because of the success of the National Ironman held here, the Scenic City will be home to the World Ironman September 9th and 10th, along with the National Ironman a couple of weeks later. And the Half Ironman will be here in May. There will be a Polar Plunge fundraiser for Special Olympics today at Finley Stadium. Channel 3's Tanisha Cordell joins us now live to explain. Good morning, Tanisha.
Good morning, Natalie. Well, it's definitely a nice day out and it'll definitely warm up a little bit, but maybe cooler for some of you guys who are going to take a plunge today for the city's Polar Plunge, benefiting Special Olympic athletes throughout the entire state. Now, I'm here with Jennifer McAvee. She's a Special Olympics coordinator here, telling us all about this event. Starts at 10 o'clock today, right?
Yes. On-site registration starts at 10, our costume contest at 11, and the plunge at 11:30.
Awesome. Now, I see this pool behind us.
Yes.
How cold is this water going to be for folks coming out to plunge?
It's a little chilly right now. Our thermometer tells us it's 52.
52. How cold is that in comparison to how it's been in the past?
Last year the water temperature was 42, so it's a little bit warmer. Not bad. So
not bad.
Definitely worth the challenge.
Yeah, so I guess feeling it's not that cold. Well, it's a little
chilly.
That's a little chilly there. So if you're coming out to plunge, it's chilly. So it's definitely a Polar Plunge, living up to its name. You gotta be brave.
But it's worth it.
It is.
It's for a great cause.
And you said costumes. People will have costumes.
Yes, costumes, definitely. We've got some great prizes for our costumes. Individuals, teams. It's worth the award.
And if you're a little nervous about getting in this water, there's going to be divers inside the pool to help out.
We keep a diver in the pool. We keep people here by the ladders to help you get out quickly. You can run straight into the locker rooms, change clothes, take a warm shower if you want to.
That's definitely the benefit of today. I mean, you can literally run straight to the locker room. They'll have towels out for you guys. Free lunch too, right?
Yes, free lunch. Chicken Salad Chick will be here serving lunch to all of our participants and volunteers.
Yeah, can't get any better than that. So coming up at 7 o'clock, I'll tell you how the community is really helping this event blast off and make it even better than the past. Stay tuned. Natalie.
Thanks, Tanisha. Well, don't let your bad phone habits get in the way of finding romance this Valentine's. As NBC's Mark Barger explains, technology can also keep you from getting a second date.
In the modern dating world, technology tries to make it easier for us to find love, but it can also keep you from getting a second date. This year's Singles in America study found there are some major tech taboos.
When we asked these 5,000 singles what really turned them off about cell phone use, the first thing that they said was they don't want somebody to pick up that phone and talk to somebody else while they're on a date unless they really explain why they're doing it.
Texting is also a no-no, and the majority also said they do not want to see their date's phone face up on the table.
They want transparency and they really want your full attention.
A cracked phone, an outdated phone, or even having that typing sound on can all have a negative impact on your first impression. So can using social media on a date.
We're so addicted to our phones, and indeed millennials are the most addicted to the phones, but we basically want somebody on a date to not have any contact with social media at all, and certainly not to complain on it.
In fact, not having a social media presence at all is considered a positive by a third of singles. The same goes for getting an actual phone call. Even some dated dating advice might also be in order.
See what a gentleman he is?
Analog romance in a digital world. Mark Barker, NBC News.
So this Valentine's Day, instead of flowers or chocolate, perhaps try putting the phone away and giving your partner some undivided attention. Well, if you've recently visited Arby's and used your credit or debit card, well, you will want to pay attention to your payment account statement. That tops our look at consumer news this morning. Malware installed on cash registers at Arby's restaurants may have put more than 350,000 credit and debit cards at risk. The fast food chain says it's removed the malware from its corporate system and is urging customers to closely monitor their payment card account statements for any unauthorized activity. The breach appears to have taken place between late October and mid-January. First, there was the Filet-O-Fish, then there was the lobster roll. Now there's this. McDonald's is testing a snow crab sandwich at four locations in San Francisco Bay Area. The sandwich consists of crab meat mixed with celery and seasoned mayonnaise on romaine lettuce and tomato between a sliced sourdough bread. But if the sandwich proves to be a success, it could arrive at more San Francisco Bay Area locations later this year. Yum.
I know, it doesn't sound too bad, actually. I didn't know they even had they must have that lobster roll sandwich up in Maine or New England somewhere. Hey, it sounds pretty good. If you plan on eating lunch outdoors today, don't look for a lot of sunshine. We could even see just a little bit of light rain later on. I'll have full details and the rest of your weekend forecast coming up after the break.
Judging was held this week for Michigan Tech's snow statue competition. These are not your average snow creations. Massive snow statues stood to be judged during Michigan Tech's annual winter carnival that started yesterday. The statues were featured all around the campus and community. Other winter fun events include comedy skits, sleigh rides, and of course a queen coronation. Look at that.
Yeah, very talented folks there.
Yeah, and that's all made of snow. You know that took
unbelievable.
Ever. My goodness, I could barely make a snowman.
I'm glad I don't live where there's that much snow where we can make this that kind of artwork, but it is
Look
beautiful.
Look at that detail, my goodness.
That's pretty awesome. I like the Back to the Future one they had.
I'm lucky if my snowman even looks like a snowman, really.
No, we haven't had enough snow around here to make a snow baby.
Yeah, we don't have much practice. We don't have any practice at all.
It's been a pretty mild winter overall. We have had some big snows just in the past several years since I moved to Chattanooga, but not this year.
Weather has been up and down, and down, and it's up this morning.
It's going up this weekend as far as temperatures. That's right. That's our top weather headline. Let's look at the live shot first. We can't skip that, of course. Our live downtown Holiday Inn camera.
Nobody's out this morning.
It's a little hard to tell when looking at the sky, but it is cloudy there. Beautiful shot of the city, though. A warm weekend. That's right. Temperatures will be well above normal, about 10 to 15 degrees above normal as far as high temperatures. We'll see a little bit of rain here and there through the weekend. Nothing too heavy, but we'll be developing through the day today and then continuing through most of the day tomorrow off and on. And then cooler weather comes back for next week, where temperatures kind of get back to normal or even a little bit below normal. Now, if you live in eastern parts of Grundy County, say near Grootley Lager and then up towards Cagle Mountain, western Bledsoe County, some spots of dense fog, so be careful traveling through those areas. That should be gone in a couple of hours or so. Temperatures in the 50s and 60s across the state. Heading into North Carolina, it's much cooler. We have just a little bit of cool air sliding down the Appalachians and across the Smokies, where temperatures are in the 30s right now, like the Murphy Andrews Airport is 36. But here in the city, it's 55, much, much warmer, 52. Down in Dalton, Fort Payne at 46, up in Pikeville around 54. Nothing popping up on the radar right now. It's really quiet. We still have high pressure over the area, although it's becoming weaker. And we're seeing just moisture in the mid and lower levels of the atmosphere developing and starting to spread that cloud cover over the area. But we're not seeing much precipitation at all across the south. It's pretty quiet. A few scattered areas of rain and snow from the Great Lakes over into New England, and that's about it. So for us, we'll have cloudy skies today, checking out the latest Vipercast, and we'll have patchy areas of very light rain or drizzle, just depending on your elevation, across the Tennessee Valley, North Georgia, and over towards Murphy through the day, and that'll continue tonight. Now, late tonight and into the first part of Sunday, the rain could get a little heavier, at least relatively speaking. We could see maybe light to moderate rain instead of just some drizzle, but we'll see overall scattered showers tonight. And at least for the first part of tomorrow, I think for Sunday afternoon, we will start to dry out. The cold front will come through tomorrow afternoon. The winds will shift. We'll start to cool down fairly quickly during the last few hours of the afternoon tomorrow as we dry out. And we might even see just a few little peaks of sunshine late in the afternoon. And then tomorrow night, mostly clear conditions and a little bit breezy Monday, but the sunshine comes back on Monday as well. It'll just be cooler than the weekend. We're not looking for a lot of rain through the whole weekend, maybe 1 to 2 tenths of an inch. So nothing to write home about there. We could use some more help. We're still in a drought. It's just not as bad as it was several months ago. 66 the high today. Normal high is 54. So we're way above normal for those highs this afternoon. A few spots of light rain and drizzle developing, and those will stick around tonight. If you're headed to the CFC game this afternoon, 3 o'clock start time, might want to bring just some light rain gear, light rain poncho or something, in case some of that light rain or drizzle pops up once in a while during the game. 58 tonight with scattered showers, and then on your 7-day forecast, some more off and on showers tomorrow, especially for your Sunday morning with a high of 70. Whoops, what happened to my 7-day? Hold on, I'm going to see if I can get that 7-day back up on the screen. I got trigger happy with my clicker, so it went right to the next graphic, and I did not want to show that yet. We want to show that warm high of 70 degrees tomorrow for folks who do not like the winter cold. And we'll have, again, you have about a half a chance of seeing showers in your neighborhood tomorrow. And then Monday will be dry, lots of sunshine, 50s, and then mid-50s again on Valentine's Day. Valentine's night, not too cold. Temperatures will be in the 40s most of the evening on Valentine's evening. And if we get any rain, it probably won't be until late evening or after midnight. So Valentine's plans, the way they look right now for Tuesday evening, it should be dry.
You're
and
golden.
Not too cold. Yeah.
Let's take a look at your community calendar for the weekend. Saturday night boxing will be held tonight at the Chattanooga Convention Center.
Starts at 6 o'clock and goes until 10 o'clock. Drinks, refreshments, all be available for you to purchase.
When we come back on Eyewitness News Weekend Today.
Really strange thing going on here. I've got a pig wandering into my parking lot.
A pig?
A pig, yes, ma'am. Bacon on the hoof.
Have you seen this little piggy at the market? Well, it took 5 police officers and an animal control employee to round her up and get her back on the truck. It's a story you don't want to miss right after the break. Stay with us.
Police in Corpus Christi got a call about an unusual character lurking around a convenience store parking lot. NBC's Anna Lee Ruiz reports.
I got a really strange thing going on here. I've got a pig wandering into my parking lot.
A pig?
A pig, yes, ma'am. Bacon on the hoof.
Well, you're not hearing things. A pot-bellied pig showed up in that store parking lot around 3 this morning. Where did it come from?
Don't know, and that's what's really puzzling, because we don't know if she was just wandering, if somebody dropped her off, if maybe she fell off of a truck, you know.
Well, the pig, who's been named Piggy Wiggy, seemed pretty happy to just wander around the parking lot. It took 5 police officers and an animal control employee to round her up and get her on the truck. Piggy Wiggy, who it turns out is a she, is now at the animal control shelter.
She's kind of been laying around all day.
I tried to get some answers from Piggy Wiggy. Easier said than done.
Can you wake up for a second?
I have some questions for you.
What were you doing last night?
Hello?
I've had some tough interviews, but I really had to go whole hog on this one. I pressed on with the questions.
Will you talk to me? Are you upset at me? Don't be mad.
Obviously, Piggy Wiggy wasn't going to share her secrets with me. So all animal care workers can do is make her comfortable and treat her sunburn. She'll be here for about 3 days. Hopefully, her owner will come forward. But don't worry, she's not going to end up as a lunch special.
If an owner doesn't come and reclaim her, of course, you know, we'll put her up for adoption, maybe even a rescue, if they step in and take her.
So if Piggy Wiggy is yours, give Animal Control a call.
Nick Austin joins us now live for another look outside.
Let's check it out. Not much happening, really. The radar is pretty quiet. Clean scan across the whole region right now. But we do have cloudy skies. It is a really warm start. 55 degrees right now. We'll have highs in the mid-60s today. About 10 degrees, 11 degrees above normal for this time of the year. But just keep in mind, we'll have just a few spots here and there of light rain and drizzle developing later on, especially during the afternoon. So just keep that in mind. Nothing heavy, but it'll pop up here and there.
And 55 is the usual high, so that's pretty
warm. I know, and we're already starting off that warm.
For Saturday morning.
Just think if we had sunshine today instead of cloudy skies, how warm it would be. Jeez, we'd be setting records.
Hey, well, there is never a dull moment for the pandas at the Giant Panda Breeding Research Base in Southwest China. Let's take a look. 3 cubs were relaxing as they ate some bamboo, and out of nowhere, a 4th came along to rustle away his friend's snack. Look at him. Very aggressive. However, the panda quickly took a bamboo branch away from the other friend. And meanwhile, another panda learned the hard way as he ended up on the wrong end of his own practical joke.
Cute little guys, though. Goodness gracious. Don't change the channel. There's much more to come. Join us for another full hour right after the break.
Coverage you can count on. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness. Coverage you can count on. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness News Weekend Today in HD.
Good morning, Tennessee Valley, and thanks for waking up with us here in Eyewitness News Weekend Today. It's Saturday, February 4th. I'm Natalie Potts, joined live with meteorologist Nick Austin for our first look at your weather this morning. Good morning.
Well, good morning to you, and hope everybody made it through the week okay. It's Saturday morning, so yeah. We appreciate you joining us, and it's already pretty warm out there, so folks may be wondering,
we're
going to set record highs this weekend. What's going on again? It's February. It's still supposed to be kind of cold, but it won't be like that this weekend. No records, though, but it will be warmer than normal, that's for sure. So we'll take a look at what's happening right now. Really not much going on. The radar is awfully quiet. Now, there could be a few spots of light rain just in patchy areas that kind of pop up during the day today, so just keep that in mind. Might need to bring just some lightweight rain gear with you if you're heading out running errands or going to the soccer game later. 55 right now and cloudy. Normal high this time of the year is 54. So we're already starting a little bit above that here in the morning. So that'll give you an idea what's happening today. No sunshine today, so we're not going to get into the 70s with record highs. But mid-60s, that's pretty warm. And again, we'll see a few spots of just some light rain and drizzle here and there during the afternoon, especially, but nothing too heavy, and it's not going to be all day, but it will be popping up off and on. So just keep that in mind as you head out.
Looks good.
Now the 7-day forecast in just a bit.
Earlier I said it was the 4th. It's the 11th.
It's the 11th.
I'm a week behind. Yeah. My goodness.
A whole week, I know, because
I'm all out of sorts.
Valentine's Day is coming up in a few days, so
I know that means I better run to the store.
Hopefully you didn't throw folks off. Wait a minute, it's only the 4th. Oh, I got 10 days till Valentine's
No, it's Tuesday this
That's
Tuesday.
Right. Don't forget.
Thanks, okay. Nick. In our top story this morning, the Hamilton County Sheriff's Office and local fire crews responded to a fire on Mahan Gap Road earlier this morning. Dispatch tells us that a vacant barn caught fire around 2 a.m. Officials say no one was injured in the fire, and the cause is still under investigation. Chattanooga police are investigating a stabbing last night on O'Neill Street. It happened just before midnight. There is no word yet on the status of the victim. This is a developing story. Stay with us on air and online as we learn more. Chattanooga's mayor and those hoping to unseat him debated some of the bigger issues facing Chattanooga last night. Mayor Andy Burke, City Councilman Larry Groin, David Crockett, and Chris Long took part in the discussion hosted by the UTC College Republicans and Democrats. All of the questions came from current students and members in the audience. Channel 3's Kelly McCarthy shows us what the candidates are passionate about.
UTC students organized the first debate between the four mayoral candidates. And in this debate, we heard each candidate explain his vision and how he would improve the city of Chattanooga.
We got to have development, diversity. I want opportunity for everybody. Everybody's important to me.
Candidates talked hopes and challenges with housing, homelessness, and crime.
I am running because I want to stop the incredible slaughter and maiming of our young people in this city.
Our violent crime is down, but we have this persistent gun violence. We have to do something about guns. We've seen this not just in Chattanooga, but around our country.
As Mayor Burke focused on his hope for the future.
I'm more optimistic than ever about what we can do. And I think that that gives me the confidence that over the next 4 years, we'll make even more progress.
Other candidates criticized his administration.
He has a failed violence reduction initiative, a failed affordable housing program, a failed workforce development program.
This is by far the worst administration in the city's history. And in most cities, most organizations in Chattanooga, the mayor would have been removed.
In 1 month, it's up to voters to choose the city's next leader.
I will put people to work and I will get people on the opportunity track. And we will look forward.
I am so happy to hear what I'm hearing tonight. The reason why is we're talking about issues that we haven't talked about before.
The candidates also answered questions on homelessness, affordable housing, and how to make young people stay in the city. These four candidates will meet again in 10 days for a forum at the East Gate Town Center. In Chattanooga, Kelly McCarthy, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
The Hamilton County Sheriff's Office is asking any witnesses to a crash that killed a cyclist yesterday morning to come forward. 19-year-old Cameron Reese was riding his bike on Suck Creek Road when he was hit by a vehicle just before 10 a.m. Reese was taken to the hospital where he died. Deputies have not released the name of the driver. If you or someone you know witnessed this deadly accident, the Hamilton County Sheriff's Office would like to talk with you. In Georgia, $10,000 is up for grabs if you can help identify an arsonist. Investigators confirm a fire that heavily damaged a home was intentionally set. The fire happened on Flora Street in Lafayette. It caused about $40,000 in damage. Call the arson hotline if you can help. That number is at the bottom of your screen. Information leading to an arrest can lead to a reward of up to $10,000. There will be a polar plunge today at Finley Stadium, and Channel 3's Tanisha Cordell joins us now live with more. Good morning, Tanisha.
Good morning, Natalie. Well, yes, I am here at Finley Stadium for the Chattanooga's Polar Plunge, benefiting more than 16,000 Special Olympics athletes statewide. Now, Jennifer McAvee here, she's a Special Olympics coordinator. She tells me this is actually one of the biggest fundraising events for those athletes. That has to be super exciting, right?
Yes, absolutely. It's very exciting. We can't wait to get this event going today.
Yeah, and it starts at 10 o'clock, right?
Yes, on-site registration starts at 10. Costume contest at 11 and the plunge starts at 11:30.
Wow. Now you guys have been setting up. You guys are still kind of getting this thing together.
Yes.
And have been setting up since yesterday.
Yeah, we started yesterday. We set up the pool. The fire department came in and filled the pool up for us. Tennessee American Water Company donates the water and then they come in and fill the pool up for us. So it's a lot of fun to watch.
Now, how deep is this pool and how many gallons are in there?
4.5 feet deep, 5,300 gallons of water.
A lot of water.
A lot of water.
And that last time we checked, it was about 52
yes.
degrees. So it definitely is polar
yes,
temperatures for sure. Now there would be some gifts for participants
absolutely.
Today, right?
Absolutely, yes. Every participant that raises their minimum, $40 for students, $50 for adults, gets our long sleeve Be Polar t-shirt,
okay.
which is pretty awesome. The more money you raise, the more prizes you get. So we have our tumbler, our lunch boxes, pajama pants, and our pretty awesome robes.
Now you gotta talk about
this
plunger
here. Our plunger. We also have incentive prizes that we award to our top fundraiser. So our very top fundraiser, of course, gets our Golden Plunger. And then we have other fun prizes, restaurant gift cards, lookouts, tickets, all kinds of fun things that the community has been awesome about donating to us. So we're really excited about the prizes we have to offer for top fundraiser team, individuals, and also costume contests. We can't leave those fun things out.
We're definitely looking forward to seeing all the kinds of characters that are going to come out to Finley Stadium today at 10 o'clock. And it runs until what time's it in?
It'll probably be done about 12:30. Once people start jumping in, they get out of that pool pretty quick.
All right. Well, we'll have more on this event coming up. Natalie?
All right. Thanks, Tanisha. Moms and dads know that having a baby is expensive, but there's a push in the Tennessee legislature to ease some of the costs for new parents. Channel 3's Lori Mitchell has more.
You don't have to look far in the Target baby section to find parents and grandparents talking about the cost of diapers.
They can be very expensive, can't they?
Yes.
It's a lot of money on top of everything else that comes with a new baby.
So as you can imagine, people we talk to are thrilled with the idea of not having to pay tax on them. New mom-to-be Sarah Daniel tells me eliminating it would help her family.
Yeah, it would be nice to not have to worry about the added expensive tax on top of the already expensive diapers that you're going to be buying a lot of throughout the course of the first few years.
A new bill is aimed at reducing the state's sales tax on diapers, feminine hygiene products, and over-the-counter medicine, freeing up more money for families. According to the website babycenter.com, during a baby's first year, parents spend nearly $900 on disposable diapers. Add that to the expense of childcare, food, and clothing, and the costs add up. At the Target checkout line in Chattanooga, sales tax on diapers is more than 9%.
If you're like me, you also have to worry about paying for childcare on top of that. So everything, it starts adding up after a while.
And that's 9% Sarah Daniel could spend on something else.
That was Lori Mitchell reporting. This isn't the first time that lawmakers have tried to pass a bill cutting tax on diapers. The bill was proposed last year but failed. Similar bills have been introduced in other states, and we checked, and right now diapers will cost you less in Georgia because sales tax there is lower. When we come back on Eyewitness News Weekend today, Nick Austin will have a full look at your forecast. Plus, we'll take a look at your community calendar. Stay with us. All right, a chocolate fair in Belgium featured models on a catwalk wearing an array of fashions, all adorned with chocolate. The fashion show was held in Brussels this week, featuring a range of dresses. Look at that. Some were short and
eye-catching. Others were sweeping floor gowns. The chocolate decorations included chocolate balls, leaves, and other confections, even accessories such as hats or earrings that had chocolate decorations on them. One designer said it took him 5 weeks just to create one dress.
I think even without the chocolate, some of those outfits were interesting.
Right.
The chocolate just adds to it.
Right? Some of them didn't even look like chocolate, just had a little.
I know, you couldn't tell first, but some neat stuff.
Chocolate flair. Yeah. I want one.
Talented folks out there in the fashion industry, that's for sure. Always thinking of new stuff, you know.
I know. What are they going to come up with next? Well, speaking of chocolate, I mean, my goodness, Valentine's Day is just a few days away.
That's right.
And you said what? Forecast looks good. Not going to be a rain out.
So far, it looks like it's going to be okay. If we see any rain over the next few days, it'll be over the weekend. But it will be warm, too. So it's a little bit of both worlds. If you don't like the cold weather, you'll also have to deal with a little bit of rain. Or if you don't like the warm weather, rather. Live downtown Holiday Inn camera, look at those cloudy skies. It clouded up pretty quickly overnight, too. But no rain on the radar yet. Weather headlines, it will be a warm weekend. We'll see just a little bit of light rain off and on through the weekend, and then it gets cooler again next week. Not only during the day, but especially at nighttime, too. We'll see some much colder temperatures. A little bit of dense fog from parts of Grundy County near Palmer, Grootley Lager, rather, and then up towards Cagle Mountain and western parts of Bledsoe County up along the plateau. So be careful traveling through those spots. That'll probably stay foggy for another hour or two before things fade away there. 57 Knoxville, a warm 60 at this hour in Nashville. Out in Memphis, it's 63. And even right here in the city in Chattanooga, it's 55 degrees, pretty warm. Now, the cold spot is at the Murphy Andrews Airport, which is several miles east of downtown Murphy, and so the higher elevations, it's only 37 there. Downtown Murphy, it's a little bit warmer. It's probably at least 40 or in the low 40s. So it's 49 Altamont, 55 for Cleveland. Dalton around 52. Winds out of the southeast now, picking up to about 8 miles an hour here in the city. So the south winds will bring some of the milder air here across the Tennessee Valley from the Gulf Coast. But we won't get a lot warmer today because of lack of sunshine. We have a low overcast across the whole region right now, with some thicker cloud cover up towards northeast Tennessee and up along the Ohio River Valley. Some scattered areas of rain and snow from the Great Lakes across parts of the northeast as well. That all stays up there, but we'll just see enough moisture in the atmosphere, at least in the lower atmosphere, that we could see a little bit of just light rain or patchy drizzle develop today. So we're not looking for a lot of rain, and it won't be widespread, but it could pop up here and there, maybe adding up to about a tenth of an inch at the most during the day today. And then the cold front comes through tomorrow, and so during the afternoon tomorrow, temperatures will start to kind of downslide a bit, especially from early afternoon onward. But after the cold front passes through, we'll see the skies clearing tomorrow night too, and then we'll see just cooler weather with a lot of sunshine heading our way on Monday. It'll be a little bit breezy, but it should be a pretty nice day to start off the week. So through the weekend, maybe 1 to 2 tenths of an inch of rainfall. Really not going to see a lot of wet weather, but patchy light rain and drizzle will be developing today. So keep that in mind if you're just out running errands, heading out to the CFC game. That starts at 3 o'clock, I believe, this afternoon. High of 66 along with the patchy light rain, south winds at 5 to 10. A very warm low tonight of 58 degrees with some scattered showers developing, especially during the late evening and overnight hours. And then those scattered showers will continue tomorrow on your 7-day forecast, especially tomorrow morning. With a warm high of 70, that'll probably be right around midday on Sunday. And then by the late afternoon hours on Sunday, we'll probably cool off into the low 50s. So it'll cool down throughout the afternoon, especially the last few hours of the afternoon tomorrow. So that, again, that high of 70 tomorrow is going to be kind of early on. And then 50s Monday with a lot of sunshine. Valentine's Day, it kind of clouds up, but I think rain will hold off Valentine's evening until late in the evening, maybe overnight Tuesday night. So we're not expecting right now to see much rain on Tuesday evening if you have plans to head out for Valentine's Day. It'll be in the 50s again during the afternoon.
Looks
good. So not too bad, yeah.
Hey, let's take a look at your community calendar for the weekend. The Valentine's Wine Dinner will be held today at the Georgia Winery.
Starts at 6 o'clock and goes until 8 o'clock. It includes a four-course meal paired with the proper selected wines.
Right.
Sounds like a fun event. Yeah.
And I mean, you've got the sunset, it's romantic, the vineyard.
Sure.
Sounds like
it's a beautiful
perfect
place,
date.
Yeah.
All right, after the break, I witnessed News Weekend today. Paul Shaheen has your sports news, an update on your UGC Lady Mocs, plus highlights from high school basketball. We'll be right back.
since rejoining the Southern Conference in 2014. Since rejoining the Southern Conference in 2014, East Tennessee State has been owned by the Lady Mocs. To be fair, though, the UTC women have done that to a lot of teams. But for those counting, the Lady Mocs had won six straight over their in-state rival since returning. Number 7 was on the line last night in Johnson City. Not a great start for the Lady Mocs. This is a turnover, and this is defense into points for ETSU. 3 points. Shamariah Bridges and Chattanooga trailed by 6 at the break. But the Lady Mocs turn it up in the third. Queen Alford slashing to the rim and the foul. They're working it outside now. This will be Chelsea Shumpert knocking down threes. Chattanooga outscores ETSU 26-8 in the third. The Lady Mocs roll 70-62. Meanwhile, on the prep beat, the state of Tennessee is almost a week away from any form of postseason play. Not the case in Georgia. It's beyond heated up at this point. Region chips were on the line last night. Our first stop was the Region 6A Boys Championship, Northwest Whitfield at Lafette. Luke Shiflett gets things started. The reverse layup to hit the deck for the Bruins. Then it's Grant Terry with the pump fake that fools everyone, draining the three to put the Bruins up 4, but Lafette didn't let that lead get away. Austin Shropshire, the bucket with ease. And then Alex Kelleher pulling up for 3. Just like that, the Ramblers are in front. But Caleb Curry counters, runaway flush, hang on to that rim. Northwest Whitfield edges Lafette by 2, 53-51. On the girls' side, Region 6-4A title, Northwest Whitfield and Heritage. Two teams they played already, and they split in the regular season. This is Sydney Smith hitting the short jumper to pull the Generals within 3. Other end, Riley Merritt dials up from the corner. Northwest Whitfield led 31-17 at the break. All Lady Bruins after that, 72-49, your final score. Lady Bruins take the region crown after 4 straight years finishing runner-up. You know, there's been a lot of firsts for the Chattanooga FC. Today marks another, their first game against the Major League Soccer team. Just so happens, it's Atlanta's first ever game as well.
They're very excited, probably a little nervous, you know. I mean, they realize that it's a David and Goliath kind of matchup, but, yeah, you know, they're excited. They know that there's going to be a lot of fans out, and they always want to perform when they're here.
Here's the details now. Tickets still available. It's a 3 p.m. start inside Finley Stadium. Decent weather ahead, so expect a crowd. Nick Austin will have you covered as far as that weather stuff goes. I know nothing other than it's decent weather ahead. That's it for sports, always more online and inside our app. Have one heck of a weekend.
Perfect.
Welcome back to Weekend Today. Jaden Maxwell, the illusionist, is joining us now live this morning to show us some tricks that are sure to surprise you and dazzle you. I know you've been on the show before, and you're just fantastic.
Well,
and
thanks.
You can
thanks
see Jaden on a family-friendly night out at some local restaurants, right?
That's right. Yeah, we have Raphael's on Wednesday nights. We have Mellow Mushroom at Hamilton Place on Friday. And coming up soon is Old Chicago Thursdays.
Nice. Yeah. Who doesn't like dinner in a show? All right, so your first trick that you have for us this
morning. I have some coins there.
And we did not practice this beforehand. I just want to tell you that.
No, just a bunch of coins. You guys can see that, right?
Yeah, just a bunch of coins.
I'm going to take one of the coins out here, okay?
And so, they look fine.
Yeah,
they're normal.
Yeah, so watch. We're going to take it. We're going to put it right over here. You guys can see that. Nothing hiding. Like, this is my early morning workout, so watch. Get a little close up right here. My hand's empty, okay? Watch. Nick, take a good peek. This is my early morning workout right here. Just like this. Look.
What?
Look.
No way.
It is.
Okay, hold on.
There you go.
Nick, I want you to try to bend this one.
I was like,
come on, Nick.
I mean, these are real coins, people.
Here, Nick, that's all you, bro. That's all you, man. That's all you.
Nice.
That's amazing.
That's an early morning warm up. It's my warm up.
That.
Isn't that crazy?
Can you bend it back, Nick?
I doubt it, but I'll try. I don't know. Let me see.
Oh, Nick bent it.
Yeah, that's a workout.
Nope.
It's a protein shake. That's the secret.
I'm not as strong as Jaden, so.
It's a protein shake. And you've got another trick here.
I do, yeah. I have a quick little card trick.
Cool.
We can't ignore the cards.
No, can't do the
cards. Love this.
So I'm going to do no sleight of hand. I've got one card in here facing the opposite direction. Mm-hmm. You guys are going to make some quick choices.
Okay.
I'm going to make a target card. So here we go. You're going to name a color, Nick, or red or black.
Red.
So red it is.
Can people do this at home too?
In their mind they can. This is for you guys, okay? So we got red, we got hearts and diamonds. Which ones do you prefer?
Okay.
Hearts
or diamonds? Do I have to tell you?
Yep.
Hearts.
Oh, Valentine's Day.
That's
maybe I should change it.
What?
No, did you guess that?
No, do you want diamonds?
I don't know.
Diamonds, hearts.
I'm under pressure.
Hearts.
I'm going to go with my first
hearts.
Instinct.
Okay, hearts. Okay, do you want odds or evens?
Odds.
Odds it is, okay? So we have odds. That's ace, 3, 5, 7, 9, jack.
Seven.
Seven it is? Now that's a common card, the seven of hearts. Seven, we went hearts.
Is it?
Yeah, that's a common
is
card.
Is it really?
Seven, yeah. Do you want to go with a different one or you want the seven?
I don't know.
Totally up to you.
I want the seven.
Seven it is.
Seven
stick
is lucky.
With, we'll
one,
stick with it.
One card in here facing the opposite direction. Let me show you, okay? Take all these out
right
here.
You're trying to talk me out of it.
Okay, look, I want to show you guys. And the reason why I use these jumbo cards is so you know that I'm not doing anything funny or phony. But look, one card in here facing the opposite direction.
No.
If that's the seven of hearts,
Natalie, I'm
going
to let you take
it
out. Go for it. Go for it.
No,
all you.
Stop it. No way.
Let it out, Nick.
How did you do that?
Express.
Nick.
I was just saying, how do you do that? I know you can't tell us, but how do you?
I did not plan this. Nick,
come on.
Did you talk before the show?
No.
No?
I swear this is not planned.
Don't play jokes.
I didn't,
on me.
Just
I had
like
no
we
idea.
Rehearsed, man. That was awesome. That was awesome.
That looked great. Okay.
All right, one
that
more for
really
you guys.
Cool.
Pretty cool.
I wish we had time to do that again and see. And,
you know
but
what?
We pick a different card.
You want to do
it
again?
Ends up being that card.
We'll do it again.
Nick is a skeptic. All
we'll
right.
do it again. I'm going to take the seven out, okay? I'm going to take the seven out.
Wait, can I see it again? Make
yeah,
sure
that's
that
the seven.
Is the seven
that's
of
the
hearts.
Seven. Yeah, that's the seven. I'm taking the seven out. We don't want the seven. We've already used
okay,
that. Okay,
so
yeah,
seven hearts
gone.
Is gone.
Okay, seven gone. Matter of fact,
seven
I'm putting the box out of the way. No confusion, okay, whatsoever. I'm going to mix these up just like this, okay? All right.
Nick's face.
All right.
We can't see
like
his hands.
Nick
okay.
Doesn't
here,
trust
behind the
anyone.
Back. Hold him behind the back. Hold him behind the back. Right there.
Okay.
Okay. I put one card the opposite direction.
Okay.
Okay. Ready?
This time I'm gonna go black.
Black.
What am I guessing?
Okay.
Spades
or clubs.
Spades.
Spades it is. Odds or evens?
Even.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay. Even it is. We're going with spades. We got an even. 2, 4, 6, 8.
8.
10. Queen.
8. I like 8.
You sure?
Yes.
You want the 8?
Yes, I want the 8.
Okay. Bring them back around. Look.
All right, here you go.
Look. So we're on eight of spades.
Okay.
Eight of spades. Look.
Nuh-uh.
It's not the one. That's not the one. That's one. I did two. Sorry. I'm sorry. Sorry. We're going with eight of spades. You guys have thrown me off a little bit. Hold on a second. Eight of spades. Here we go. Eight of spades. Eight of spades. Eight of spades. Look. Yep. Right there in the middle. See, I knew I stuck one in the middle. Eight
no
of spades.
No way. That's hold the one. On.
Eight of spades!
That's
all
impossible.
All right, good. Now you got one.
Eight of spades.
All right, do
you
we have time
trick?
For another quick one?
Yes, one
yes,
more.
Yes, we have one more.
We have
and
one more.
Is,
okay.
I think this is supposed to be the best one.
This is going to be the best one.
Okay,
all right.
This is a lighter, normal.
Yes, so in the mornings, we always have to floss, and I teach my kids to floss, but this is something I grabbed on the way out. My kids right now, they have at it in the mornings with the dental floss, and I'm telling you. So I grabbed this morning. I hope that you guys enjoy this.
All right.
This is really cool. So, Nick, hold on to that. Just tug on it, right?
All right.
It's legit, right? Okay.
That's legit.
Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. Strike the lighter there for me, Natalie.
It's not dipped in kerosene, is it?
No, not dipped in kerosene. That's a different trick. We don't want that one. Go
okay.
for it. Go. Just like this. That's one. Go again. Two. Nick, you can see that, right?
Nick, I want you to
oh,
do
yeah.
the
yeah,
one.
Yeah, there we go.
Go for it.
Ready? All
can
right.
you get a close up?
Yeah. You guys are silly, man.
One more.
All right,
he's
there we
really
go.
Burning
that's good.
That.
That's
okay.
good. All right, so
it's in a bunch of small segments.
Yes,
now.
There they are. You can
and I
see,
bet you're
right?
gonna put them back
we're
together.
We're gonna try to put them back together. Yep. Here we go, just like this.
All right.
Watch, little ball here. Like so.
I don't want to blink. My eyes are
do
burning.
Do not blink. I'm telling you, do not blink. Look right here.
I'm
look.
Trying to watch your every
blink.
Move, my
watch.
Friend.
Stop it.
Watch. Come on.
I'm amazed.
Here. Oh. All you, pull.
Yep.
I'll take the ladder back. You're going to hurt somebody. Go for it.
It's legit.
Right?
It's back in one piece.
It's magic. Okay, so tell us where families can see you again.
We got Raphael's on Wednesdays. We got Mellow Mushroom on Fridays. And we got Old Chicago coming up on Thursdays.
Now, you've been doing
wait,
magic
that's Raphael's whole... where?
That's Hamilton Place.
Oh, at Hamilton Place. Mm-hmm. Okay, good.
No, I love okay. him because he's local and he's been doing magic yeah. his whole life. Any advice out there to young magicians who want
oh,
to be
absolutely.
Really good?
Absolutely. Drive. Do not stop. Do not give up. Go. And always be happy and put other people before yourself. And I'm telling you, that's true magic. It's connecting with people, man.
And coming to you for tips.
Coming to me for tips.
For help,
or you,
right?
can, you can give me tips. Yeah, you yeah. can give me tips.
But that's the smile good. That you get is really the true
oh, it's
magic.
Awesome. Yeah. Yeah, it's awesome.
Thank so. You so much, Jaden, for coming on the show.
I love you guys. Thank you so
lots
much.
Of
I'm
going to
be thinking
man.
About that dental floss all morning long.
We'll don't wait so long to come back this time.
No.
We'll be back right after this. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
coverage you can count on. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness News Weekend Today in HD.
Good Saturday morning, Tennessee Valley. Thanks for waking up with us here at Eyewitness News Weekend Today. I'm Natalie Potts.
I'm meteorologist Nick Austin, and boy, if you're just tuning in right now, you missed a treat. Our friend Jaden Maxwell, the ultimate magician.
Magician.
Some great
Nick
tricks.
Nick is all out of sorts this morning.
I am, because every time he does these tricks, I'm like, how do you do that? Of course, he can't tell me, but they're just amazing. So, but we'll have, maybe we'll try and put his information on our website. Because
yeah,
we want folks to know where he's
performing.
Yeah, you
can see him at the Mellow Mushroom downtown Chattanooga, yeah. 6 to 9
Raphael's
on Fridays.
Up at Hamilton Place, too. Yeah. He'll be doing his shows. Anyway, quick look at the weather, because we got to get to the news and all that, too. But we'll have highs in the 60s today. A little bit of patchy light rain and drizzle will be popping up. But other than that, no big worries today. So it's going to be warmer than normal, just no sunshine. So you won't really need your sunglasses. But maybe keep a lightweight rain gear with you in case you get one of these spotty showers in your neighborhood this afternoon or at the soccer game this afternoon, which starts at 3 o'clock. We'll have more on the weather later.
All right, I'll take it away. Thanks, Nick. In our top story this half hour, Chattanooga police are investigating a stabbing late last night on O'Neill Street. It happened just before midnight. There's no word yet on the status of the victim. This is a developing story. Stay with us on air and online as we learn more. An early morning fire heavily damaged a downtown building. It happened around 1 at the corner of Martin Luther King Boulevard and Douglas Street in a vacant building. The intersection was closed during rush hour while crews battled the blaze. Channel 3's Tim Pham tells us how firefighters worked to keep this fire from spreading to nearby UTC student housing.
It took firefighters about an hour to put out this massive blaze. They say when they arrived on scene, they saw thick smoke and flames spilling out of the building.
Out of control.
Cell phone video sent to Channel 3 shows an orange glow from a large fire overnight.
This fire right here by Douglas Heights. It's going up in flames.
The blaze broke out early Friday morning. Firefighters had to break into the abandoned building formerly known as the Half Note Lounge, but the situation became too dangerous.
But once the fire broke through the roof, they realized they had a substantial fire on their hands, so they called for a second alarm response, bringing in an additional 6 fire companies.
Smoke hovered over the area. Witnesses say they heard a loud noise around the same time of the fire, but investigators still aren't sure what started it.
I heard this boom sound, and all of a sudden I come out, and this building down the far end was engulfed in flames and fire.
The fire was just feet away from UTC student housing. The fire didn't damage the structure, but smoke seeped into the building. Douglas Heights residents got this message asking them to shelter in place while the scene was active.
Asked them to close off the vents to prevent smoke from this fire from getting into that building.
Investigators say the building is a total loss, but thankfully no one was hurt. Douglas Street remains closed because firefighters say some of the walls are crumbling. We're told building inspectors are monitoring the condition. Reporting in Chattanooga, Tim Pham, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Thanks, Tim. Well, the Half Note Lounge used to be in that building, but the owner says it's been vacant for years. We'll update you as more information becomes available. Friday was part of a long weekend for lots of students and teachers across the Tennessee Valley as a number of school systems in our area canceled class again due to the flu and other illnesses. That list included Sequatchie County, which is also closed this Monday. Doctors say flu germs can spread to others up to 6 feet away, and closing schools for a few days is a smart choice. Well, Valentine's Day is just around the corner, and if you're looking for some love in your life, we have a 4-legged speed dating event for you that you might be interested in. It's today from 10 a.m. until 4 o'clock at McCamey Animal Center. Animal lovers will have the chance to meet adoptable dogs and cats in hopes of making a match. Participants will have up to 8 minutes to create chemistry with each animal, and all of whom have individualized biography cards to help pet seekers find their perfect match. All right, there's going to be a polar plunge fundraiser for Special Olympics today at Finley Stadium. Channel 3's Tanisha Cordell joins us now live with more. Good morning, Tanisha.
Good morning, Natalie. Well, yes, I am here at Finley Stadium where the 2017 Polar Plunge will be taking place at 10 a.m. today, and it benefits more than 16,000 Special Olympics athletes statewide. Now, I'm here with Jennifer McAfee. She's a Special Olympics coordinator, and she tells me that this is going to be benefiting a couple of counties, right?
Yes, there are 9 counties. Area 4 is what covers Chattanooga and surrounding counties, so we're really excited about the money we're raising for this event.
Now, what's the goal today as far as donation-wise?
Our goal for the Chattanooga area is $20,000, and we're really close to making it, so we're hoping, fingers crossed, we're going to get there. I know we are.
Yeah, and you're close, and it hasn't even started yet. We haven't even kicked off
yet. Right, yeah. Between sponsorships, Chattanooga community is amazing to help us out. Mm-hmm. Sponsorships, online fundraising, the people that are taking the plunge today have been great mm-hmm. at raising money, and so we're really excited and proud of what they've been able to do.
How important is the community and just helping this event, you know, be successful?
Right. We couldn't do it without the community. Our sponsors, our people that have donated, our restaurants, our, you know, the lookouts. Mm-hmm. We've had so many great community involvement that we couldn't do it without them.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome. Now, again, this starts at 10 o'clock is registration opens, right?
Yes. On-site registration open at 10. The costume contest at 11. The plunge starts at 11:30.
And you don't have to take the plunge, right?
No. Come out. Cheer everybody on that's doing the plunge. They've worked so hard, and we really want you to come and cheer and watch. It's a lot of fun to watch. We've got people in crazy costumes. Come out and see what they do. It's fun.
No, and it's a great. You have the polar plunge taking off or kicking off at 11, and then the soccer game at 3.
Yes.
So a lot
can't
of
beat it. It's a lot of activity going on today.
Yeah. Oh, awesome. So make sure you come out today at 10 a.m. Support Special Olympics athletes all throughout Tennessee. Natalie.
All right. Thanks, Denisha. We will be right back after this. Stay with us.
Welcome back, live downtown Holiday Inn shot. We have cloudy skies, but a nice shot of the city overall anyway. We'll take a look at what's happening outside right now. It's really pretty quiet out there. As far as temperatures, it's warm too, 50s and 60s all across the state right now. It's really warm out there to start for a mid-February morning. Normal highs are around the mid-50s, and we're already starting that warm here in the city. It's 57 in Knoxville, 60 in Nashville. Now in Memphis, it's 63. Right here in Chattanooga, 55 degrees, 49 Altamont, 55 Cleveland, The cold spot is out at the Murphy Andrews Airport in North Carolina, with a pocket of 30s there where it's 37. It's 52 down in Dalton. Southeast winds around 8 miles an hour here in the city. The radar is awfully quiet right now. There's not a whole lot happening except maybe just a few patchy areas, very, very isolated patchy areas of light rain or drizzle. And that's what we'll see today. There won't be a lot of rain on the radar, and really across the Great Lakes and the Northeast is where most of the rain is, parts of the Mid-Atlantic as well. There's not much happening across the south, but with the low overcast today and just moisture increasing a bit, we'll see a chance at least for some patchy areas of light rain and drizzle to develop during the day. So keep that in mind if you just have to be out running errands. Maybe you're going to the CFC soccer game this afternoon. That starts at 3 o'clock. And there's that polar plunge down at Finley Stadium too, from about 10 till noon today. Hopefully the water in that pool is going to be really cold because the air temperatures are going to be pretty mild. It's not going to feel like a true polar plunge out there with temperatures near 60 degrees at midday. But we'll see some more areas of scattered showers popping up tonight and through the morning hours on Sunday. And then a cold front moves through around the early afternoon, give or take, on Sunday. We'll start to dry out, but the winds will shift. It'll be out of the northwest tomorrow afternoon, and temperatures will start to drop fairly quickly during the last few hours of the afternoon, from a high of around 70 down into the low 50s by late afternoon, and then down into the 30s as we head into late Monday night, or late Sunday night into Monday, rather. Monday will be nice, a lot of sunshine coming back. It'll just be a lot cooler than what we're going to see this weekend, but not a lot of rain with the system. It's not a strong cold front, and it's not going to contain enough moisture to bring us a significant or beneficial rainfall, because we still have a drought across the area, maybe 1 to 2 tenths of an inch of rain through the weekend, and that's about it. But about half of the viewing area, give or take, is still in a severe or extreme drought, so that's why we need some help with rain. Just areas of patchy rain and drizzle today, 66 for the high, scattered showers tonight, warm, low of 58. In your 7-day forecast, more scattered showers on Sunday, especially in the morning. But check out that high of 70 degrees for tomorrow. And then Monday, it'll be colder with highs in the 50s, but that's still pretty nice with lots of sunshine. Valentine's evening, we'll probably see temperatures in the 40s. The rain should hold off until mostly after midnight on Valentine's night. We'll be back right after this.
Welcome back to Weekend Today, Jerry. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Weekend Today. Jerry Tessman joins us now from Dale May Jewelers with some absolutely gorgeous pieces to show you for Valentine's Day this year. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
Well, thank you for having me.
It's always a pleasure to have you. And my eye is already drawn to a couple of pieces on this table. They're just absolutely beautiful.
Well, thank you. We think so too.
Okay, so let's go down here. This piece is just stunning.
This is Annie glass. It's made in this country. Mm-hmm. It's in the Smithsonian. And it's wonderful.
And you're saying you can also serve out of this, right?
You can. This piece, no two pieces are alike. Mm-hmm. And some of them are more open, that do open up to serving out of them a little more. Probably this would be a piece that you would...
I don't think I've ever seen anything like it, really.
Well, they're wonderful. All of her pieces are signed. This mm-hmm. one is signed on the side here.
It's just beautiful. It catches your eye. And then my eyes are also drawn over here to this nice pink color.
Well, that truly is a salad bowl or a serving piece. Mm-hmm. And the wonderful thing about that is it doesn't have to be stored. You can leave it out.
And what I love about Dale May is that you have a variety of items for anyone, really.
We do. We are, at least we try to.
So if you're not looking for that ring, or you're looking for a heart-shaped dish, for instance.
These are wonderful. On the heart-shaped dish, that is 24 karat. Mm-hmm. It works well as an hors d'oeuvre. It is beautiful as a dessert piece.
This would be nice to dress your table.
Absolutely.
For that romantic dinner.
Absolutely. They work well for anniversaries, Valentine's, and bridesmaids' gifts.
Now, if you are looking for that special Valentine's gift, you've got some nice heart-shaped pieces over here. I love pearls. Pearl's my birthstone. I love pearls. But which one of these would you say is your most popular?
These are all popular.
They're all popular.
These are in a good price range, which makes a difference. Mm-hmm. And the girls your age and younger love the pearls with something on them. They're not
ecstatic
as just pearls.
Oh, I know, and they're so classy. And this would be a nice gift, I think, for maybe a teenage daughter.
It is.
Or a niece, maybe. Oh, my goodness. And this bracelet, too. It's beautiful. And then what is this stone right here?
That is morganite. And
I have never heard of that before, but it is just gorgeous.
Well, please play with it. The girls are loving the lighter stones. We're doing lighter sapphires. This morganite goes with everything, and it is in rose gold. And there is a band that goes with it. It can be used for an engagement ring.
And you were mentioning, oh my goodness, wouldn't this be a gorgeous engagement ring? I'm just going to take it off here, because you were just mentioning how you undercut the diamonds.
We try to always undercut our pieces so the bands fit snugly.
And so when you really put that on, I don't know if you can get a close-up of that. Look at that band. It is just gorgeous, and it fits perfect.
Yes, it should. It should. The finished look is important.
Now, can you get custom jewelry? Can you come in and design your own piece?
Yes, yes.
And how long would that take?
Well, that usually takes 3 to 4 weeks, because then we do renderings. So, and the renderings come back to you and you approve them.
Wow, how special is that, though, that you can take part in that process?
Well, it's fun. It's fun.
I love this ring. I want to take it home with me.
It is looking for adoption.
Now, another thing I want to highlight are these bracelets here. You say that they're really easy. Something I can't stand in the morning is when I'm sitting there and I have to call my husband, come over here. Can you clasp this for me? But this is perfect. I love this banglet here, right here.
Well, it is tempered gold, which means that it moves. And putting them on is as easy as this.
Look how easy that is.
And there is no problem of them coming off.
And look how that pops too. Now, can you wear more than one?
They are done as stackables.
I want to see what two look like.
Okay. This is yellow gold. This is the pink or rose gold again.
Wow. Beautiful.
And you kind of have to get a knack for putting them on a little bit. But They do. They just stack beautifully.
Those are gorgeous. All right, and then you have a couple of dishes over here.
Once again, we are back to Annie Glass, and I brought these because spring is coming. People do a lot of outdoor entertaining. But the great thing about this, other than the fact that they're hand done, you can put them in your dishwasher, is the fact that they go inside just as well.
You can put these in your dishwasher?
Yes, yes, yes.
Nice.
Well, you might, if you feel, it's very substantial.
Wow, these are gorgeous. They're just so different. I love how different they are.
And the color, there's a bit of green in them. The texture is done with salt. These plates are called salt. And I don't know about the true making of them, but they get the texture mm-hmm. with using salt.
Wow, very interesting. All right, so thank you so much for coming on the show.
Well, thank you for
having
me.
And obviously, if you go to Dale May Jewelers, you can find the most absolute perfect Valentine's gift for your sweetheart. There's her number on your screen and her website. Thank you
yes.
so much for coming on the
thank
show.
Thank you. Thank
and we hope
you
that you find that
me.
Perfect gift for that somebody that you love. We'll be back right after this. Stay with us. Nick Austin joins us now live for another look outside.
Here's your 7 day. Once more, it's cloudy. It'll stay cloudy all day. We'll just have some patchy light rain and drizzle developing. Nothing really too wet out there, but some spots of rain. 66, it'll be warm. 70 with scattered showers late tonight, tomorrow morning. But Sunday's high will be around 70 around midday and then cooler for next week. Valentine's evening so far at this point looks like it'll be rain free.
Yeah, looks good. Yeah. Hey, we want to end with a smile. An Idaho family had quite the unusual intruder last week. Take a look. This elk crashed through a window well in a basement of a home. Officials were able to get the elk to leave by smacking it on the rump with a hockey stick found in that basement. Officials are urging residents to cover their windows because, hey, you never know. And somebody wants to come bunk with you. Thanks for joining us.